Hi guys, welcome back to Vista Study Visit. So today I am here with the lesson called as Angel in Disguise. Okay, this lesson is written by T.S. Arthur. Okay, so the lesson is completely as the title suggests, Angel in Disguise. Okay, so let us move on towards the lesson. About the poet, we have mention the video in the I button. You can go there and you can learn about the poet T.S. Arthur for more information. As the title refers, the angel in disguise. Okay, so here there will be a lots of question in your mind. Who is the angel? What is the story? And all. Okay, so to remove your all doubts, we are summarizing the lesson and I am expressing it in front of you. Okay, in a very short and a sweet manner. If I say that it is a 10-page story, okay, obviously it would feel little boring to read and to continue the anxiety or energy in the lesson. So we will begin with the story without wasting our time. So please hit the like button if you like the story. And please subscribe if you are new to my channel. Okay, so now coming to the Angel in Disguise. Angel in Disguise is a story of an little girl, Maggie. Before moving to the Maggie, we will learn about her mother. Who will be the mother of Maggie? Okay, she will be a complete ill-tempered woman in the society. Okay, as referred in the lesson. The mother of Maggie will die at a certain point in her own drunken fit. Own drunken fit refers to she will be completely drunk and uncontrollable by anybody. So what happens here? The woman dies at a particular moment by her own house threshold. Okay, so that she will leave behind the three children, the three young children. First will be John, second will be Kate, and third will be Maggie. Okay, John will be young enough to work with the farmer and earn for his livelihood. Kate also will be across 11 or 12 years old. Okay, so that she can also survive for herself if a proper guidance is needed by anybody, any of the people. Okay, apart from this, the leftover part is Maggie. As the woman had a bad image in the society, nobody liked the woman. Okay, I am talking about the Maggie's mother. Nobody even liked the woman. They don't want to talk with her. They don't want to quarrel with her. The woman was completely ill-tempered, bad-mannered, always quarreled with the people. So this situation brings us to a point, people doesn't like the woman. Okay, but as the death news of the woman spread around the village, okay, mouth to mouth or by listening by somebody, the people who were having the anger in their own self, that anger has been converted into the pitiness. Okay, all the people of the society were now showing mercy towards the children, not towards the woman. Okay, so the woman is died and left behind the three children, that is John, Kate and Maggie. Okay, so John, Kate and Maggie are very poor. As I said, they belong to a poor family and they didn't have a proper house. They lived in a small single room hovel. Okay, so all the people came, they saw the things. People started to talk about the children. Who will keep the children? We can't leave the children starving like this, right? So all the people of the society, of the village, started to discuss what to do along with the children. Okay. Hence, they started discussing one of them in the public, named as Mr. Jones. Mr. Jones, he was a farmer. Okay, he opted John. He selected John to work in his fields. He was a farmer. As he was a farmer, he can teach many things to John, and he can teach many things to John, and even he can get useful work from the John, as he was wealthy, and even the height according to weight and the mind sharpness was also good of John. Okay, so farmer will opt John. So now left with the Kate and Maggie. Mrs. Ellis, a woman of the village, she will be searching for a bounded labor. She needed for herself a bounded labor. Hence, what she decided to take Kate. Okay, Kate was even healthy and very much ill-disciplined when we compare to mother. So the structure here given is she is ill-disciplined. So Mrs. Ellis will tell clearly that I will take Kate with me, but I have to work on her. I have to make her disciplined. I have to make her to bring in a proper path. Okay. So what happens here? The Joan has been selected by Mr. Jonas. Kate has been selected by Mrs. Alice, who needed a bounded labor. Okay, this is the complete scenario of first day of the woman's death. Okay, as the day completes, the people will talk about Maggie. They will start to talk about Maggie. What about Maggie? Where to leave her? Okay, this was the major question now among the people of the village or the society. Okay, so there was a call that she should be left to poor house. Here poor house referred to an orphanage. Poor house referred to an orphanage. Okay, the people thought that there she might be getting a proper care, medication, doctoring, everything. People can as why this is the illusion? Because Maggie in her childhood has fallen from the window and broken her backbone, spinal cord, completely. Even she can't sit by herself, she can't walk by herself. No work can be done by the Maggie. Okay, hence all the people will decide that she is no useful for anybody. Hence someone else should work for her. Okay, this thought, this feeling will bring the people to the baddest condition of the Maggie. Okay, nobody will opt Maggie, but they will decide that they will leave her to the orphanage or the poor house. Okay, this is the complete situation of the first day of the woman's death. Okay, all the people decided, they went to their homes, and next second day all of them came back to take the woman in the coffin, okay, and bury her in the burial ground. Okay, or the graveyard, what we call. Okay, so as the woman was put into the coffin and the dead cart starts to move, nobody except a few members followed the dead cart. Okay, after that, Jonas said John to sit in his wagon and Mr. Jonas left from the place. Okay, feeling that he has done his duty very well. And now, Mrs. Ellis ordered Kate to tell goodbye to her own sister. Okay, now the sisters, the both Kate and Maggie are completely in the grief of losing mother, and now they are being separated as brothers and sisters. Okay, so hence they will be having a feeling, they will cry, they will bid a goodbye to each other, and even Mrs. Ellis will take Kate and move from there. One by one, the people starts to move from the house. At last, nobody will remain in the house. Only Maggie will remain. Okay, at this particular situation, a blacksmith's wife will enter into the hovel. Hovel, a small room. Okay, she will enter into the room, house of the Maggie, and she will bring some good clothes and bed sheets to dress up Maggie, and she will change the Maggie's dresses. She will make her clean, neat, and she will put her on the bed. As she will put her on the bed, she will start to collect the remaining utensils of the house. remaining utensils, materials, because Maggie can't do herself anything. Even John is not there, Kate is not there. So what blacksmith's wife will decide, let her collect all the remaining particles of the house which will be useful for her. Even she will collect a small particles and even a needle to her own work. Okay, as she will be the blacksmith's wife, she will be making use of those utensils and the leftover items in the house. Okay, so this complete situation depends upon now Maggie. Okay, so now a new character is introduced, that is Thompson. Okay, Mr. Thompson. Mr. Thompson will be not having any children. So the character of Mr. Thompson in the lesson is described as he will be child loving person. As the couple was Mrs. and Mr. Thompson was not having any children, he had a soft corner in his heart for children's. Okay, as he was a wheelwright, he was mending the vehicles. He was mending vehicles, whatever the vehicles may come to his shop, he used to mend the vehicles. Okay, so hence for this particular matter and situation, okay, Mr. Thompson will be crossing over the Maggie's house. Okay, he will see who is in the house. Only Maggie will be present in the house and blacksmith's wife will be collecting all the items of the house. Okay, by seeing that, he will ask where, what to do with this little girl. Okay, Mr. Thompson will ask to blacksmith's wife. Okay, so what blacksmith's wife will tell, as yesterday we have already decided, let us leave her to the poorhouse, take her to the poorhouse. She will herself order Mr. Thompson to take her to the poorhouse. Okay, and she will move from Maggie's house. She will not stay for a minute or a moment also. Okay, later on, Mr. Thompson will observe Maggie. Okay, Maggie will be completely filled with the tears in the eyes, that face was showing the expression of grief, sadness. Okay, these all were mentioned on the face of the Maggie. As Mr. Thompson was a child lover, he was having a affection towards the child. Okay, he never retrieved the children. Now he decided to take the Maggie to his house. Maggie will tell in a soft, painful voice, she will tell, Mr. Thompson, don't leave me here. Okay, so Mr. Thompson will tell, no dear, I am not leaving you alone. He will carry the Maggie in his arms and he will move towards his house. He will not go towards the poor house. He will go towards his own house. Okay, now the character appears of Mrs. Thompson. Mrs. Thompson or Jane Thompson, what we call. Okay, the wife of Mr. Thompson, Joe Thompson, is Jane Thompson. Okay, she will be observing that husband is bringing the child, Maggie, carrying her and bringing her to the home. Okay, this complete situation will be observed by Mrs. Thompson. Okay, as the Thompson bring the child into the house, Mrs. Thompson will question, why have you brought her here? Why have you brought the sick brat? Brat refers to the unconditional thing. Okay, the unconditional thing or unacceptable thing. Okay, why you have brought her here? Okay, Mr. Thompson will not speak a single word. He will directly go towards the chamber, a small cabin of his house. He left the bag, Maggie, on the bed and he will come back. He will come back to speak to the Mrs. Thompson. Now, what is the character of Mrs. Thompson? Mrs. Thompson was hateful for herself. She never loved anybody, not even herself. Okay, she always used to hate the things. She always used to hate the people. And she always have a negative mentality. Okay, so whenever Mrs. Thompson will be angry or will be in such a mood of quarrel or something, Mr. Thompson never used to talk here. Okay, he used to come silently go for his work. Okay, so hence this situation has come now. Mr. Thompson has brought Maggie to his own house. Okay, now what will happen? Mrs. Thompson asked a question. Why have you brought the Maggie to the house? Okay, he will not tell. His eyes will just warn as wait, I'll come back and speak. Okay, he will leave the Maggie in the cabin and he will come back to Mrs. Thompson to speak with her. Okay, she will come and stand in front of her and he will talk. So, what happened? Mrs. Thompson will ask to Mr. Thompson. Okay, wife will ask to the husband. So, husband replied, this poor child, nobody was going to take her. Hence, I brought to her to the home. Okay. So, Mrs. Thompson will ask, wife will ask, where are John and Kate about the sister and brother? She will ask. Okay. Mr. Jonas opted John. Mrs. Ellis opted Kate. Okay. He will clearly mention the information. What did he know? Okay. But nobody was ready to take Maggie. So this wife will reply, then why you have brought her here? Okay. So the call was to take her to the poor house. Take her to the poor house. You would have continued. Why you brought her to the home? Okay. So what Mr. Thompson will reply? He will quote the Bible verse. He will quote the Bible verse that a single person who will help with a glass of water even is rewarded by the God. In that case, in that situation and scenario, you are not ready to help a small child. Okay. So, he will be having hard feelings over Maggie. To the particular situation was not controllable by Mr. Thompson. So, he will quote the Bible verse and he will also tell that women's hearts are not hard as men's heart. Means women have to show the womanhood. Woman is always loving. Woman is always affectionate. Woman is always supportive to the things. Okay. This has to be built in the woman's character. Whereas Jane Thompson was completely opposite. His wife was completely opposite to the situation. Okay. Hence, he will warn his wife by telling that wait for one day, today I will go and search the guardians. Okay, within 2-3 days as I get the guardians, I will leave her to poor house. If no guardians are getting for Maggie, I will leave her to the poor house. By telling this, he will turn his face off and he will go for the work. Okay, this is the actual situation. What will happen? Okay, so Mrs. Thompson will not speak a single word. She will understand the point and she will leave. She will be quiet. Okay, Mr. Thompson will be working in the wheelwright shop, his own shop. Okay, and he will be one of the richest man of the village. Okay, so what he used to do, whenever the children bring something to mend, something to repair, he used to do it free of cost, or whatever the money they have, he used to take from them. Okay, not as a condition, this much only you had to pay, this much is the charges, nothing like that. Okay, as the soft corner for children, the love and affection for children was holding in his heart, it never made him do take such an action. Okay. So, the character of Mr. Thompson is clearly mentioned here. Okay. He went to the shop. He worked for whole day. The sunset has come. Okay. And he will realize that I should go home back. He will come back. While coming back, he will see that the cabin in which the Maggie he left, there was a light. He will observe that the light has been switched on of the Maggie's room. Okay. Obviously, wife will on the switch, right? Wife will on the switch, right? So, nobody else is in the Thompson's house. Either Mr. Thompson or Mrs. Thompson has to do the work. As Mr. Thompson is working in the shop, nobody was there in the house to work with it. Okay, so he will come to know that, yes, Mrs. Alice has been switched on the light. Okay, and he will see while coming to the home, he will see from the window that Mrs. Alice is sitting in front of Maggie and talking to the Maggie. Okay, so by seeing this situation, he will feel quite comfortable and happy. Okay, he will feel quite comfortable and happy for his work, what he has done. Okay, he will silently enter into the house and he will ask Mrs. Thompson, when will be the supper ready? Supper refers to the dinner. Okay, supper refers to dinner. So, Mrs. Ellis will reply, yes, within a few minutes it will be ready. I will prepare. She will ask for the kitchen. She will run. Okay, after a few minutes, Mr. Thompson will freshen up himself and he will come and sit in front of Maggie and he will start having a conversation between Maggie and himself. Okay, he will ask, what is your name? Maggie will reply in a soft, painful voice, my name is Maggie. Okay, he will ask a few more questions like, doctor is regularly visiting to you or not, that this. Okay, and how many times it would pain for you. Okay, when it will hurt you and what are the situation. So that Maggie will reply, yes, doctor will visit me every period of time. Means I think for a 15 days or a month. Okay, yes, doctor used to visit me regularly, but since so many days he has not visited. Okay, so that Mr. Thompson will ask, when did you hurt? Does it pain a lot? The spinal cord, the backbone. Okay, so that Maggie will reply, yes, when you lifted me morning, it pained very badly. But now, since I am on this soft bed, I am feeling comfortable and there is no pain at all. Okay, the joy, that smile, sweet smile of Maggie makes Thompson to feel happy. That energy, that relish was very good on the face of the Maggie. Okay, hence this conversation was going on. Mrs. Thompson will come and she will inform that the supper is ready. Okay, as the supper was ready, Mr. Thompson will just indicate his eyes from here to there, from wife to Maggie. What about her? His eyes questioned, what about Maggie? Okay, Mrs. Thompson will reply that, let us have first and later I will bring something for her. Okay, so both the husband and wife went for the dinner. They sat on the dining table. Nobody spoke about the matter of Maggie. Okay, but as the dinner was going to an end, Mrs. Thompson asked just a word, what about Maggie? Okay, so that Mr. Thompson will reply, as I said you before already, tomorrow I will go and meet the guardians. Okay, until then, wait. Okay, so now the dinner has been completed. Mrs. Thompson will bring a butter, bread and a hot milk for Maggie. Okay, Maggie will eat it with lots of relish and happiness. Okay, Mrs. Thompson will ask, how was the food? Is it good? Okay, so Maggie will reply, yes, it's so good. It was clearly visible on her face that she was happy with the food. Okay, so next day morning, this completed the second day of the woman's death. Okay, next day morning, the third day morning, while having the breakfast, okay, Mr. and Mrs. Thompson were having the breakfast. Okay, at that particular situation, nobody improved the matter. Nobody wanted to talk about the matter of the Maggie. But Mrs. Thompson, by herself, she will inform husband that if the girl stays for 2-3 more days, not an issue. She is very sick. Let her get a proper care from our side. Then no problem. We can leave her to the poorhouse. Okay, this verse will be said by Mrs. Thompson. Mrs. Thompson. Okay, so by listening to this, the Mr. Thompson will be a quite satisfied and relaxable. Okay, on that day he will not go to see the guardians for Maggie. Okay, not any upcoming day. Hence, it clearly shows Maggie stayed along with Mr. and Mrs. Thompson. Okay, who has brought a happiness? Mrs. Thompson's behavior has completely changed. She started to love herself. She started to take care of Maggie. She started completely being cool and calm. She never quarreled with the husband. Okay, so the message here author is trying to send us is a woman cannot be without her motherhood. Okay, she can't be surviving without her womanhood or motherhood. Woman has taken birth to love, to take care, to affection, to provide self improvement. Even she needs some love and affection from the people, and she should also give your love and affection for others. Okay, so this was the major story of Angel in Disguise. This is the complete story of Angel in Disguise, where Mrs. and Mr. Thompson had a happy life by bringing the angel. Who is the angel here? Maggie. And she was completely disguised. She was having a backbone problem. She can't help anybody. But when she came to the house, the complete environment of the house has been changed. This is the story of Angel in Disguise. If you like the story, please hit the like button and subscribe to my channel. Thank you.